All right, guys, welcome back to the show. Let's just get into it. So today we have Electric Light Orchestra's Discovery. So with any video, we first start out with some facts. So this album was released on the 31st of May, 1979. It was recorded between March and April of the same year in Munich, Germany. When this first came out, it had topped the UK record charts, and it was the first ELO album to do so, and it stayed there for 5 weeks. The album spawned 5 singles, which is Shine a Little Love, The Diary of Horace Wimp, Don't Bring Me Down, Confusion, and Last Train to London. The album was released very well. Received very well at launch and had good reviews. By this time, Electric Light Orchestra had fully developed their signature sound instead of their Beatles-esque with orchestra stuff, like their previous album, Out of the Blue. This was all produced by Jeff Lynne, and he also did lead vocals, guitar, which was electric and a 12-string acoustic, the vocoder, backing vocals, orchestral and choral arrangements, and like I said, producer. Bev Beaven was drums, percussion, and backing vocals. Richard Tandy was piano, synthesizer, Wurlitzer electric piano, clarinet, lead guitar on track 6, backing vocals, and orchestral and choral arrangements. And Kelly, I'm gonna butcher that, Gorkut was bass guitar, backing vocals, and lead vocals. So that about does it for the facts. Let's check out my copy. So if we look at it right here, we have not a whole lot of ring rash, just a little bit up here. And that is actually from the crease. But, you know, just the normal wear from being moved in and out of a crate or a stack of records. Just looking on the front here, we've got a Parisian looking guy holding up the ELO spaceship, but it's like a medallion. I don't know, don't ask me. And then I'm saving the back for last, so I'm not gonna show you the back yet, because the back has some very interesting stuff on it. Then we have same Parisian guy with the ELO medallion, and then some baddies up here. It's pretty cool landscape. It's out in the desert somewhere. I have some stuff over here, which is just credits. But let me show you the back real quick, which is where things get very interesting. So this is the back of my record. Obviously, these were not sold with this. But I'll just cover some of this up first before you start getting a peek. Right here, we have track listing and all that. Down here, we have this with another Parisian guard. I can't tell what's behind this. Has taped up, but you know, barcode. And this is actually one of the telltale signs of what this is. This is for promotion only. Ownership reserved by CBS. Sale is unlawful. So basically what I did is broke the law. That's cool. Let's get into this, what this is. So this first sticker says CM. ELO puts out a SOS, same old crap. I used to really like these guys, but they become as boring as clam dip. At least there is side 1, track 3, side 1, track 4, and side 2, track 5. And then, in different handwriting with a different blue pen, someone says, frick off and die, this is great. Here we have what seems to be a typed out label. It says the in red, now predictable formula music from ELO. Have never been a big ELO fan, and the disco numbers on this haven't improved my outlook. But this will be a monster, and there are some strong cuts. Side 1 track 2, side 1 track 4, side 2 track 2, and side 2 track 3, open 6/7/1979, Bill. And then I cannot make sense of any of this, but these are the track listings. So side 1 track 1, side 2 track 2, on and on, side 2 track 1. but there's little notes underneath, and I'm not totally sure what that all is. But here is my hypothesis on what this particular album is. So, when you release an album, right, and you send it off to disc jockeys and reviewers of your album, this, I believe, is a review copy or promotional copy that went through some reviewers, which is what these two things are. Because this one is also... No, never mind, it's not signed. But it has initials here, CM. And this one says Phil. So I believe that those are reviewers. I don't know what this all is. But it has the CBS for promotion only sticker, meaning that this was given for free by Jet Records to CBS. So that's why the sale is unlawful, because I wouldn't make any money off of it, even though I bought the record. But, you know, this album is from 79, so it's quite old now. But, you know, let's pull this, pull the record out and check out the slip jacket. So, as you can see, it is a themed slip jacket. So right there we have our boy Jeff Lynne, and we have Bev Beaven, I believe, Richard Tandy, and then Kelly Grohrcutt, I think it is. I really feel bad for butchering his name. But a little nerd out session, we have what appears to be a Les Paul. It has the P90s and speed knobs, so I'm guessing it's a 50s. And then right here we have a boy Kelly, and he has a Hofner bass, which is now known as the B bass for Beatles, but I believe that's like a 100/1. Or 10-100, I don't remember. And then we have Richard Tandy and Bev doing their thing. Let's pull the record out. Check it out. So it has a very striking center label. It has the Jet record, and it appears to be a building with like spotlights off of it, which are yellow and pink, which I think is very cool. And it says Electric Light Orchestra Discovery. That's side two. Let's flip it to side one. So reading off track listings, we have 1, Shine a Little Love, 2, Confusion, 3, Need Her Love, and 4, The Diary of Horace Wimp. And do a little shuffle. And then side two, number 1 is Last Train to Ludden, Midnight Blue, On the Run, Wishing, and Don't Bring Me Down. Now, Don't Bring Me Down is probably one of the band's greatest hits, besides Mr. Blue Sky. So, of course, that would be the last track on the album, because I guess they already knew that it'd be a big hit. I really like the song, and that's going to be the playing demo for this, if it doesn't get taken down, which hopefully it won't. But you never know. I uploaded the Steve Miller Band, and that had a playing demo in it, and I thought, well, you know, it's Steve Miller Band. No one cares about Steve Miller Band. And guess who got a copyright claim on his video? This guy. And then same thing happened with Chicago. That got partially blocked. No copyright claim, though, but it did get partially blocked in some parts of the Middle East. Don't ask me why that happened, but that happened. But hopefully ELO and Jeff Lynne, they're cool guys, and they let me do a little playing demo for you. But I really don't have much else to say about this. It's been a little bit of a shorter video. Might even keep it under 10 minutes. Not sure yet. But this has been RNC Music. And I am out.